fabric patch, and we just finished our 10-20-30 class out here at the event center, which is our retreat center here in Soap Lake. We had a great time. It was 10 things that you can do for under $20 in less than 30 minutes. It was actually more like 35 things, but the most popular thing, I think, was this little trick with the table runner. So I wanted to go through it one more time so that when everybody got home, they would remember all of the details, and we thought we would just share it with everybody since, I guess, you maybe weren't able to come. So it's a really cool table runner. You just have to kind of follow us through to the end because it gets really neat. But it uses a ruler with a 60-degree angle and border fabric. Has to be border fabric. So what happens with border fabric is you almost always have four repeats, or at least you should, because the whole idea is that you're going to miter your corners, right? And you'd have one for each side of your quilt. So when you pick out the border fabric that you want to use, determine where your equal borders are, because you might decide that you're only going to use this part right here, or you might decide that you want to use this part right here, but you should have four equal borders. So if you have four equal borders, I've looked here and I've determined that my equal borders are come to the bottom of this little ribbon part right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it in half, because for this trick I really only need two. So since I only need two, I'm going to save this one up here for a future project. It can either be the back, or it could be a whole second project. Again, though, if you wanted it to be bigger, wider, you just wouldn't have this extra piece. You could kind of modify what your strips would be. All right, so once you've done that, now you're going to do the same thing. You're going to figure out where this border is. And this border goes from here to here, and you can kind of see where I've cut it, and from here to here. So we're just going to kind of do the Vanna White thing and see if this works, and you can see where we've cut it before. So we're just going to work right now with this border piece, and what we're going to do is a 60-degree angle. So first we're going to start by getting our 60-degree angle going. So my best tip in using your ruler is to make sure that your ruler is right side up, right side out. So, you know, that means don't turn it upside down so the numbers are hard to read. Don't turn it over so the numbers are backwards. Just keep your ruler exactly the way it's supposed to go so you can read the numbers. And what you're going to do is you're going to find that 60-degree angle. You generally have one at the bottom of the ruler, and you generally have one at the top. But instead of trying to line it up and figure out where that cut is, the easiest thing to do is you kind of know what you're cutting. So I know that I'm going to get this going so I can cut a triangle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of put it where I think it's going to go and then find my line. So sure enough, I know I have to cut there. I'm going to slide this up. I'm sure you can't see it there, but I can see I have this 60-degree line right here. So I'm going to line this up. So here's my 60-degree line, and I'm going to cut this with my rotary cutter, which gives me this funny little wedge. And here's my 60-degree angle. Now, a 60-degree angle, that's an equilateral triangle, so it's the same on each side. So I'm going to go ahead and turn, and I know that my next cut is going to roughly be there, so I'm going to do the same thing. I'm not going to flip anything over, trying to line anything up. I'm just going to take my ruler, tip it to where I think, and then look for my line. And sure enough, I can see here's my 60-degree line right here. I'm going to slide that down so that I have a nice edge right there. And then I'm going to cut with my rotary cutter, and here's my next cut. And I'm going to cut three times on one side. So I'm going to do one more. And again, I know I'm cutting a triangle. I'm going to start up here at the top. I'm going to line this down, look for my 60-degree line, bring that up, make my few little adjustments that I need to, and cut that. So I've made three cuts on one side. I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Now, people think that that seems weird because you're cutting backwards, but it's exactly the same thing. I know I'm going to make a wedge, so I know I'm going to cut over here, and after I kind of get the ruler where I think I want it to be, I'm going to look, and sure enough, here's my 60-degree line. I'm going to slide it down so it's right on that line. Then I know that my angle is exactly right. Cut with my rotary cutter, and there's my wedge. Cut my next triangle, and again, I know it's going to be like that. Here's my 60-degree line, bring that up. Cut my line. And again, three cuts on each side. I'm gonna do one more triangle, cut my line. There it is. Okay, so I've done three cuts and I have this, what did we decide this was? Trapezoid. We don't know what this is. We have a piece. I'm gonna do the exact same thing with the second one. Now, something has happened, so I'm missing a piece, but I'm gonna cut my wedge, turn, cut my triangle. There's one. So that would have been my third cut. And on this other side, this might be hard to see. So here's my little wedge, second cut, third cut. Now, here's my next triangle. Now I want to mention that, well, I'll mention this in the end. So now I'm gonna put it all together. Put it all together, and what's happening is the whole thing is gonna come around. So this is coming around. See, I have blue on the outside edge. Green. Green on the outside edge. Put that one there. Put this one here. Put this one here. Whoop. And this one here. And it makes just this fantastic table runner because it just brings everything around so that it's continuous. If you have just a really nice fall print, a poinsettia print, you can do this for all sorts of seasons. I started with 54 inches. That's sort of the nice number to get a size that looks just like this. If you have a really long table, you can certainly go ahead and do 2 yards if you'd like to do that. And again, you can modify the width if you modify your strip, right? So I wanted to do 4 equal rows because I want to now make a second one with this one. And it's important that your rows be identical. But if I wanted to make it narrower and just do just this guy, you know, you can do that or make it bigger. The other thing I want to mention is that this is cut so that the green is on the outside edge. If you wanted to do it opposite and you wanted this to be on the outside edge and the green in the center, what you want to know is that however you start is how you'll end. So if you start where this is out this way, you're gonna end that way because you're doing 3 cuts, right? You're doing 1, 2, 3. So if you wanted this to be bigger, you would have started this way, 1, 2, 3. I hope that makes sense. All right, so I'm gonna put this up here and then 2 last things to show you. One is that it's only 5 seams. So to sew this together, you're just going to sew your seam right here, sew your seam right here, do the same thing up here, and then sew the middle together and you're done. The way that I would finish this is I would just find a backing and a batting, put right sides together, sew around, leave it open, turn it right side out, and then just top stitch. Maybe find a few spots to stitch in the ditch to finish it, and that would be done. You could use this for the back, but again, I would make a whole second one. You also can fuss just a little bit if you want, you don't want 2 sleighs in a row or whatever. You can flip these around a little bit. That doesn't matter. The other thing I want to show you is that you have these odd little pieces left over. And these odd little pieces that are left over will make a little hexagon. So you take this one. You end up with 4, but you have these weird little wedge pieces, one from each end on each strip, so you have 4 of these. So what you actually have to do in order to get the other 2 pieces is you take these little wedges and you sew them together. So I didn't mention this at first, but when you make that very first cut, I don't know if you can see this or not, when you make that very first cut to start your wedge, give yourself about 1/2 of an inch so that you have enough for a seam allowance to sew this together.
because that's what will happen down here, is these, you'll sew these together, and that's what's going to give you other pieces. You don't have to do this, but it's kind of nice because then there isn't one single wasted piece of fabric with this. So anyway, I hope it makes sense to you. I hope you think that's a fun thing to do. It's a good thing to do with border prints and a really good exercise for you to use your 60-degree angle. So wish you would have come. It would be good seeing you, and stay off the roads.